what's up, dudes? My name is Prestige. Welcome back to the channel. Today we are playing on Evac. That's weird. It's been a while since we've played Evac. We know we've been playing a lot of Skyjacked, been playing a lot of the DLC maps, so I'm actually happy to bring you a different map that isn't DLC, and we're going to be using the Weevil. I actually have a suppressor on there with the quick draw handle and the foregrip, but I wanted to talk about this weapon because it seems like the hot button is hashtag buff the Weevil. Been seeing a lot of it lately, ever since Nade Shot actually said that we should buff the Weevil. And of course, when someone that has a huge following, especially in the esports community, as well as just the Call of Duty community in general, there's going to be a huge outcry for something like that. We've seen it over the past few years for multiple things, but buff the Weevil is the newest crusade that's being led by our very own Nade Shot, which isn't necessarily a bad thing. However, I think that there are mixed feelings in the community when it comes to this. So over on Twitter, I posted a short video clip of me just getting like 4 kills with the Weevil. It wasn't nothing special. And I asked the question, do you guys think that the Weevil needs a buff? Leave your opinions, and I would love to talk about them in the video. So we're going to be going through some of those things that people said, and I just want to once again discuss that in this video here today. So let's just start things with my personal opinion, all right? Because I'm using a suppressor here, I got the Weevil, and I just wanted to try to make it the worst that I possibly could and see if I could do good with it. And honestly, I thought I did pretty well with it. For somebody that doesn't necessarily use the Weevil a lot, I got Dark Matter on it, and that was pretty much that. But my personal opinion states this, that I just don't think it's overpowered. I don't think that it's underpowered. I think it's perfect right where it is. It's got the nice amount of ammunition, which is 50 rounds without extended magazines. You're able to just spray and pray to your heart's content. If you happen to miss your enemy, you could just follow up by spraying, which you'll see happen a couple of times here in this video. And I just feel like the damage over range, it's a little bit less than I'd like it to be. So in that aspect, maybe buff it there. But in the same sense, you have to remember that this is a submachine gun. It's not an assault rifle. It's not something that's supposed to kill at super long ranges. So in that aspect, I really do think that it's balanced. But let's head on over to Twitter and see what some of you guys were saying. Jesse says that the Weevil is fine. The Razorback needs a fire rate increase, the Vesper needs less recoil, and they need to quit nerfing. That's one thing that a lot of people have been saying. I've actually been accused here that I'm the reason they're nerfing weapons, which, if that was the case, if I had that big of an influence, honestly, I'd be like, yo, fix the glitches here, stop nerfing the weapons, everything's fine here. If we went back to day one, where all the weapons felt pretty much on par with each other, I think I'd be fine. There really wasn't too much of a problem with the Vesper. I thought the Vesper was alright, to be completely honest with you. It did have a really fast fire rate, and I think that was intended because it's pretty much the Scorpion of this game. Remember the Scorpion Black Ops 2? How it had a really fast fire rate, it ran out of ammunition really quickly. As to where the Weevil in this particular game is kind of like the PDW from Black Ops 2, which was one of my favorite weapons. It literally has a similar ammo capacity, it has a similar fire rate. It's pretty much the PDW all over again in Black Ops 3, and I don't think anybody could argue with that. I don't necessarily remember the community going in an uproar for an increase to damage or damage over range with the PDW in Black Ops 2, but then again, Black Ops 3 is a completely different game and it does have different feelings. Now, the next thing that a lot of people were saying were maybe just buff the damage a little bit. Make it one less shot to kill. Make it something like the CUDA, like make it similar to other SMGs or comparable to assault rifles. And I don't know if that's necessarily the best way to go about things. I think that that might actually break this weapon and make it a little bit too powerful. Because remember, we have a 50 round magazine we're dealing with here. The fire rate is pretty good. I mean, the only thing that I could think of, and a lot of you actually mentioned this, was maybe buff the rapid fire for this weapon, just for this weapon. Make it a little bit more aggressive. Make it a little bit faster just for this weapon. And there you would have a pretty nice balance between ammo capacity, how much you're gonna run out of it, and then of course the damage over time, because you're gonna have to think about, if you're at a longer distance, of course it's gonna take more ammunition. If you are at a super far distance, you're gonna have to flutter fire or burst fire that weapon even to just lay down ammunition on them. And if you're using rapid fire at that range, you're not really gonna be doing good. So even at close quarters combat with this weapon right now, it's a complete monster. It's beastly, and I really don't think that it needs a buff. So for those of you that are saying buff the Weevil, I'd love to know why. Leave a comment down below. Let's have a discussion. If you guys enjoyed this video today, make sure to click the like button down below. Don't forget to subscribe for more awesome videos each and every day. And until next time, I am out. Peace. Hey everyone, thanks so much for joining me at the end of the video. If you missed yesterday's video, make sure to click the annotation on the screen right now, and don't forget to subscribe over on the second channel where we're almost at 15,000 subscribers. Thank you guys so much for all the continued support, and I'll see you tomorrow.